Starting with the fabric, this is a satin back crepe. So on one side it has that gorgeous satin and on the other a more matte crepe side, and it's in this beautiful teal colour. And on to the cutting out. This is my skirt back. My fabric underneath is on the fold and I have a notch at the top and bottom of the fold line. So now this piece is ready to be joined to the front at the side seams. I have two layers of fabric underneath and a notch at the top and bottom of the center. So just laying that front over my back, my fabric is right sides together and ready to stitch. Sewing here at my 1 cm seam allowance, starting and finishing with a back stitch. So I've ran those edges through the overlocker and pressed, and this is the result. Happy with that. So now this piece is ready for the flounce. This is my back, my fabric underneath is on the fold, and I have a little notch at the top of the fold line. And just like before, this piece is ready to be joined to the front flounce at the side seams. I have two layers of fabric underneath my pattern piece and that corresponding notch marking the center. Laying that front over the back, right sides together and pinning. And ready to stitch. At my 1 cm seam allowance, starting and finishing with a back stitch. So I just need to finish those edges and press, which you can see I've went ahead and done here. And before I add my flounces to my upper skirt, I just want to take care of the hem. And for this one, I've chosen a narrow rolled hem, which I'm going to sew in 2 stages. So I've just folded my hem up by about 3/4 of my hem allowance, and I'm running a stitch as close as I can get to the fold line the whole way along. And before I can finish my rolled hem, I just need to trim off that excess hem allowance. So cutting as close as I can get to the stitch line without going through it. I'll finish that off camera. So that's that done. So now just folding once more, and this time stitching right along that inner crease edge. Using a little bit of a longer stitch length, back stitching to start and to finish. So this is a good method if you don't have a rolled hem foot, or if you do and you're just not very confident with it. This is quite a feel-safe hem, which I really like. So that's now I had a good press. Super happy with this. And now that that's done, I'm ready to add my flounces to my upper skirt. My fabric is right sides together, lining up my edges, my side seams, and my notches. And pinning into place. Stitching here at my 1 cm seam allowance, starting and finishing with a back stitch. So my edges have been finished, that seam's had a press, and I just want to add one final touch here, and that's a little bit of top stitching. So stitching here on the flounce side, about a millimetre or two away from the seam you've just seen me sew, using that same longer stitch length as before, starting and finishing with a back stitch. So this is just going to help that seam lay flat and also give a nice bit of finish to the outside. And after one final press, this is how it looks. And now the very last thing I have to do to prep the skirt is just run some gathering stitches along that back waist. So using the longest stitch length on my machine, popping my finger in at the back of my foot, stitching here within my seam allowance. So that's that done. So that's my skirt fully prepped and ready to be added to my bodice at the waist. So on to the bodice. This is my back. My fabric underneath is on the fold. A couple of notches to mark the bottom of my dart legs, popping in a pin to mark the point of the dart, and then another couple of notches at the top and bottom of the fold line. So now to draw in my dart legs, I'm first of all going to replace where the pin pierces the fabric with a chalk mark. And then line my ruler up with that chalk mark and my notches. And draw in my lines. Ready to pin. Matching up my notches at the bottom, popping my pin in through the chalk line on top, coming out through the line on the bottom and back up through again. And ready to stitch. Starting at the point of the dart this time, sewing right along that chalk line and finishing with a back stitch. So I'll tie off my threads and give those darts a good press. And this is the result. So now my back is ready to be added to my front at the shoulders. I have two layers of fabric underneath my pattern piece. And to provide the shaping, I have double darts. So just like before, notching the bottom of the legs, popping a pin in at the point, one final notch at the center front, and then I'll mark those darts off camera. Pin. And ready to stitch. So stitching in exactly the same way as I did the back. Just finishing my second dart here. And they've had a good press off camera. One final bit of prep work here is just to run a line of stay stitching along the neckline. So using a tiny little stitch length here, sewing about a millimetre or two inside my seam allowance the whole way down. I've given that a press and now this piece is ready to be joined to my back. My fabric is right sides together. And ready to stitch. So that seam's been finished and pressed, and in preparation for sewing up my side seams, I've just ran those through the overlocker as well. And here, just laying my front over my back, right sides together and pinning. And I'm going to stitch one side from the waist up to the armhole and on the other about a centimetre or so above the waist up to the armhole. That's just going to leave a little gap for me to put my tie through later on. So that's my little gap just above the waist. And then on the second side, stitching the whole way down. And I've pressed those seams open, which you can see here. And now that that's done, I'm ready to finish off the armholes. And on this dress, I've decided on a bias finish. So I've pressed the end of that bias tape in underneath. And I'm just lining it up here with the underarm point, popping in a pin and ready to stitch. Sewing at my 1 cm seam allowance. And when I get back around to my starting position, just trimming off the excess bias, laying it on top, and stitching through all layers. Finishing with a back stitch. And just like I did on the hem before, I need to trim that excess seam allowance. So taking off probably about 2/3 here. Pressing the bias away from the bodice, but making sure that that trim seam allowance in underneath is butted up against it. And ready to understitch. So stitching here through the bias, through the trim seam allowance, about a millimetre or so away from the bodice. Using that longer stitch length again, and this understitching is just going to help that bias to sit nice and flat and tucked away neatly in underneath. So now to finish the bias, I just need to take care of that raw edge. So I'm just folding it in underneath, folding again and pressing into place. Ready to stitch. This time stitching along that inner crease edge, using that same longer stitch length, starting and finishing with a back stitch. So I've given that one final press, and this is how it looks. Happy with that. So now my bodice is ready to be joined to my overlay at the neck. My fabric underneath is on the fold. I have a notch at the fold line and one to indicate the shoulder. So before I can add this to my bodice, I have a little bit of prep work to do. The first of which is to run a line of stay stitching right along the neck. So just like the bodice before, I'm using a tiny little stitch length, sewing about a millimetre or two inside my seam allowance. And what this will do is stop that neckline from stretching out too much while I'm putting this dress together. So that's had a press. I've also treated this hem in exactly the same way as I did the skirt hem. It's had a press. And now that that's done, I'm ready to join my bodice and this piece together. So my fabric this time is wrong side of overlay to right side of bodice. Lining up my centre back notch, my shoulder notches, and my centre front. And pinning. And stitching here about a millimetre or two inside my seam allowance. Starting and finishing with a back stitch. So that's my bodice and overlay joined. So now that that's done, I'm ready to add my bodice to my skirt at the waist. My fabric is right sides together. lining up those center notches, lining up my side seams, taking care to make sure that that little gap is still visible and I don't stitch the whole way over the top. Lining up my center fronts. And ready to stitch. Back stitching to start at my 1 cm seam allowance. And finishing with a back stitch. I've ran that edge through the overlocker and pressed. I've still got my little tie hole at the side visible. So the next thing to do is to add those ties. So I've just cut 2 strips of fabric, joined them along the center and pulled them right side out. And here just lining them both up with each side of the waist and popping in a pin. And ready to stitch. Sewing again within my seam allowance, back stitching to start and to finish. So now I just have one final thing to do to finish this dress, and that is to close up the neckline. And just like the armholes before, I've decided on a bias finish, and I'm going to run my bias from the center of the neck at the back, the whole way down to the bottom of the skirt. So following exactly the same steps as before, running my first line of stitching at my 1 cm seam allowance, which off camera I've trimmed. Now running my line of understitching through the bias, through the trim seam allowance underneath, about a millimeter or two away from the dress front. And when I get to the bottom of the hem, I'm trimming the excess bias, tucking it in underneath and stitching right across the top. And now for my final line, I've just pressed that bias in underneath, hiding that raw edge, sewing along the inner crease line, and when I get up to the neck, I'm making sure that I'm moving that overlay out of the way so that my stitches are all hidden nicely in underneath. Finishing with a back stitch. So that's my neckline all completely finished. It's had a press. And my stitches around the neckline are all nicely hidden underneath the overlay. And with that, this little dress is complete. So I have my overlay all attached around the neck, all of my stitches nicely hidden, as I said, that lovely rolled hem at the bottom, the shaping at the front provided by those double darts, my skirt attached at the waist, those gorgeous ties, that nice bit of flounce at the bottom of the skirt, and this is how it looks on. So I could not be happier with how this has turned out. I love every detail about this one. The overlay up around the neck, I love how it finishes just above the elbow. The fit of that bodice with the double darts is so nice. The length of the skirt, how the volume in the skirt is added below the hip, I really like that detail. The ties at the waist, it is super comfortable. This fabric feels very luxurious. The perfect little holiday dress for me. I absolutely love this one. So I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you've not yet subscribed, please do. And I shall see you on Friday. until then, I hope you have a fantastic week. Bye, folks!